concert. My name is Joe Welter, and I have been serving as the interim principal this year, originally for 9 weeks, and it's ended up being the entire year. I would just like to take a moment to thank all of you for raising such resilient children. We have had, needless to say, a very challenging spring. Things came at us very quickly. We were fortunate enough in the end to find Gina Ketter, who is retired orchestra director from Mount Lebanon, and she has been serving in this position as a substitute. I promise you, she has not been doing this for the money, but out of the goodness of her heart, to be working with these kids. And I greatly, greatly appreciate her commitment these last few weeks to help these kids get prepared for this concert. I also have to say thank you to this wonderful, wonderful group of kids who have persevered and stuck it out. They really are a great group, and they have stayed with it, and I think you're going to be pleasantly, pleasantly surprised with the concert this evening. So without further ado, Ms. Gina Ketter.
Perseus by Soon-Hee Bulbul.
And this piece contains rhythmic figures and soaring melodies.
And it is sure to catch your attention and grab you along for the ride.
Once again, we thank you for coming to our spring concert. Enjoy the show!
I just remembered, we are video recording this, and it is going on the YouTube channel. And I've been asked if you could just be not very in the way with your phones as you may be taking your own videos. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
introduce our guest conductor, Maria Evers.
My name is Ian Bautista. I'm an 11th grade. I'm a violist. Our next piece is Voyagers by Richard Meyer. I don't have anything prepared because it's the last minute. So it's a really fun piece. I have a really good time with this, and I hope everyone has a good time. Thanks.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Sean Maddox. I'm a first violinist, and I'm in 12th grade. Before I introduce this next piece, I would like to just give a huge thank you to Ms. Ketter for coming in and just teaching us and supporting us. Next up is Enid Bach, which is, funnily enough, arranged by our very own Ms. Ketter. So if that doesn't show her determination and just care for us, that I don't know what does. It is a fugue, which starts with a little melody and then develops it by interweaving it between the entire orchestra. And it also might sound familiar because it is also an arrangement of the song "In Black" by Rolling Stones. you can tell my young age by me blanking on that one, but I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you.
So what we're going to hear next is an arrangement by none other than John Maddox of a song by King called What About Us? And they're doing this from memory, and he did the arrangement. It's amazing. So we have Liam Devers. We have Linda Cortenka. We have Kevin Walsh. And of course, John Maddox as the Short Tears Valley High School String Quartet playing What About Us? Okay.
Thank you. along with our very own Dylan Evans. Please give them a round of applause. This piece is called Iditarod, and it's composed by Sunhee Newbold, who, as you might have noticed, has written quite a few of our selections thus far. Iditarod means distant or a distant place, and it's also the name of a dog sled trail. And Newbold's composition tells a tale of a long and exciting journey through the tundra. Please enjoy Iditarod.
Thank you.
My name is Dylan Evans. I am a senior violinist and a new bass player, along with Olivia. Let's also give her a round of applause. One of our next songs will be Greater Than, written by Brian Belganis. For context, when Mrs. K was helping us with the song, she asked for a bass player to learn the part for the concert. Now, my first thought was I have no experience playing any other instrument other than violin. So naturally, I raised my hand first. To no one's surprise, I sounded amazing on the first try, and now the song is fully complete. We hope you enjoy Greater Than.
Thank you.
Well, we hope that was a nice little palate cleanser from all the dramatic music. That wasn't that just gorgeous, that greater down? Okay. We're just taking a little break here because I want to do some awards first. This has been quite an experience for me, and I have to say I love this group, and I really looked forward to every morning coming just to work with them at 8:30 in the morning. It was worth getting up at 6:30 again after being retired, and just to see this group, and in the middle school too, really wonderful kids. So we have a couple of awards that apparently are standard for the high school orchestra at the end of their year concert. And the first award is going to be for the best, I wouldn't say best, but let's just say the designation of the rookie of the year. That would be our ninth grade or our freshman. And I had the orchestra vote because I haven't been with them long enough to really understand their dynamics that well. So it turned out we had a tie from the vote. And would these people please come up? Kate Bittner. And they are deserving of it, very much so. Okay. Our next award, again voted on by their colleagues, is for the most improved player. Of course, like I said, I haven't been here long enough to really see that, but I have seen amazing growth just in this 8 weeks that I have spent with them, of all of these folks. And like I said, I came into this, they were so prepared already, it made it really easy for me to do that. So, for this Most Improved Award, it goes to none other than Kevin Trahan. Okay. Now, I did have a little input on this one, but again, this is another award. This is for the Orchestra Musician of the Year. And we did, again, have a little input from the orchestra. And it was a tie. And I didn't want to break the tie because I totally agree with it. So would Gwen or Zempa please come up and talk to us? Because, of course, they've stuck with orchestra since, what, third grade?
Yes.
Third grade. Long time, yes. Yeah, you guys know that, don't you? That's a long time. It takes that kind of dedication. It takes that kind of effort to see this result. This wasn't just a miracle that happened up here. This is these kids really working it, plus all of their academic and their probably intramural activities. So I want to just give them a round of applause. I think they're all amazing. This orchestra, I'm just like, I have a helper who's helping me, I believe, retrieve something behind the piano. Thank you. So I'm going to call their names up one at a time, and this is to recognize our seniors. Starting with a young lady who has joined the orchestra, Leanne Lee Brayshore. You're a senior, correct? You're not a senior, never mind, sorry. My bad. She will be. We're recognizing her early. She seemed like a senior to me. Okay. All right, so first senior to recognize is Sal Elizabeth Herzler. Thank you.
Bachelor.
A young lady who's helped me a lot, she decorated the stage. She helped me with music theory. Where's Emily at? Emily Quinn, come on up. And we also have Anna Wilcox. Please come up.
Thank you.
I hope you realize how wonderful these people are and how wonderful it is to have you supporting them. So thank you all very much. I hope you have a great rest of your year. I'm going to do that too. Thank you, Orchestra. Thank you, Shore Valley administrators and everyone. Have a great evening. Thank you.